everybody. It's me, Jessica, your health fitness program manager from McLean, and I'm here today to guide you through our 30-minute express core and stretch. We're gonna get started in about 4 minutes, so you've got plenty of time to prime up your pets, to create some space for yourself, to put up an away message if you need to grab a glass of water, to put music on if that's what's gonna inspire you to keep going. We've got a great mixture of some core strengthening and balance related exercises and some total body stretches. If you happen to have some weights, you might want to bring a weight along for the very end of the workout. Feel free to grab some water. There won't be any particular water breaks, but as always, you're welcome to grab water when you want. I'm just gonna make sure everything looks like it's coming up. Roses on the interweb. All right. That's what I like about these workouts. I get older and they stay the same age. Cool. So do whatever feels right for you, whatever feels organic over the next like 3 minutes before we get started. Step up, get away from your desk if you can. Maybe just wander the hallways of your home or walk in circles around your office or just spin around if that feels right for you. We are going to get started standing, so you're welcome to take any seated stretches that feel appropriate, but do know that we shall be getting up. I'm going to take my socks off. You know it's going to get serious when I take my socks off. All right, and we got 2 more minutes before we get started, so do you boo. Checking on my new pet. Yeah. I've adopted a spider. I don't know if you're one of those people who likes to kill spiders. I try not to kill my spiders. Oh. You tripping over there, Uncle Buck? There you go. Now you won't trip on the wire. So yeah, I got a spider growing. I'm making an amazing web in my bedroom, in the window, where I, surprise to no one, have more plants growing. And I really enjoyed seeing, it's a very, like, hardy web. It has very few bugs in it, so the spider's a little misguided in its placement. But you know, thanks for helping to keep things clean and my plants look good. So maybe you'll think about that before you murder your next spider as well. We got 1 more minute till we get started. We do have some forward folds coming today. Some big separate leg stretching motions. If you know that reaching down to the floor is a big challenge for you, even with legs separate, I encourage you to bring a block or maybe hang out near your couch or a chair somewhere where you can find support. Just do what works for the body and mind that you have today. Let's move. It's on. All right, so come to a comfortable standing position, feet either side by side or about hips width distance apart. Relax your shoulders down away from your ears. Really take that stretch of your fingers down towards the floor to decompress those shoulders and make sure that you have taken any excessive arch out of the back. So possibly even taking a little tuck of that pelvis forward just so that you're not, you know, sticking those glutes out. Start to bring the weight into your heels. Find a pulling down and back of the shoulders, but make sure as those shoulders go down and back that you didn't bring this arch back. And if you did, knit that rib cage together so the core is nice and tight. Let's take three big breaths right here. Focus during your inhale and expansion of your rib cage of keeping it close together. Sorry, expansion of the diaphragm without trying to expand the rib cage too much. So as tight knit of an abdominal section as possible. On your next big inhale, you can bend your knees. Let's go ahead and reach all the way up towards the ceiling. Keep those fingers up towards the ceiling. Take a nice gentle side body stretch. Drop one arm down and reach the opposite arm up overhead, back to center. One arm comes down, reach up overhead. Do your best as we're taking these side to side reaches to not collapse through the chest. So instead of looking down towards the floor, keeping that chest squared towards the wall in front of you. And maybe if you're feeling super open, ooh, to get an extra little stretch, even looking up towards the ceiling. So making sure that you keep that nice lift. Maybe you're moving a little slower than me. So take the time to get one more on each side. Keep that core drawn in. You've got this. All right, and when you're finished, arms up overhead, relax those shoulders down, pull that belly back in, keep the weight in your heels, and then on your next exhale, relax your arms down by your side. Let's warm up the hips just a little bit before we get into our ab work. So perhaps you need to hold on to a counter or start to work on your balance. Length through the crown of your head. We're just gonna gently warm up our hip flexors, kicking back and forth about 5 times in each direction, making sure that you're trying to limit the swaying. So if big kicks have your whole body moving around, keep it to a smaller kick. Awesome. And once you got 5, let's switch to the opposite side. Remember, it's totally okay to hold on to something if that's also going to help you to find that length to challenge your core. Once you've got 5, we're switching to tick and tock. Ooh, feeling that on the outside of the hip. Just getting about 5 in and then switching to the opposite leg. So we're not moving super fast because moving super fast is going to make those shoulders really wiggle too. We're moving nice and slow. One more warm-up move. Go ahead, draw one knee up, open it as much as possible, bring it right back in and down. Let's do that 2 more times. Up, find that big open without turning your hips, back in, down. Keep that weight in your standing leg heel. I know there's a lot of temptation, at least for me, to bring it into the ball of the foot. Let's switch to the opposite side. Bring the weight to your heel, squeeze that glute, belly in, draw your knee up. Bring it out as much as feels good for you, in and down. 2 more. Up, out, in, down. Last one. Up, out, in, down. Cool. All right, so the first exercise we're going to go for today, warming up a little bit more of the back of those legs, are some good mornings. Up to you what you'd like to do with your arms. For good mornings, you can reach them up overhead and do your best to keep your biceps by your ears and come down nice and flat. Feel that stretch on the back of your legs and lift yourself up. Or if your shoulders are really hurting, maybe knuckles right by your ears so you're not applying any pressure to the back of your head. Also option to just cross your hands over your chest and take that forward hinge. So we're coming down with a nice flat back. We're going to hang out here for just about 30 seconds. Let's go ahead and begin. Find what works for you. Draw that belly in. You can take a slight bend of your knees. Weight stays in your heels. When you feel that big stretch on the back of your legs, lift up. Make sure you still have those shoulders down and back, engaging through your back with that big lift of your chest. Ooh, really feeling that in those hamstrings today. Let's get 2 more in. make sure as you bring that forward hinge in that you keep your belly drawn in. Just getting that in your mind for later, and then go ahead and relax your arms down by your side. Shake them out for just a moment. We gotta move. We're gonna do on one side and then the other. So bringing those fingers back towards your ears, but no pressure on the back of your head. It's gonna work that chest a little bit more to stay open with those elbows drawn back. We're gonna go for an elbow to knee crunch and then a forward kick. Let's make 1 minute happen on one side. We'll make 1 minute happen on the other, and then we're gonna stretch out. So bring those arms up, open your chest, shoulders down and back, draw your belly in, begin. Elbow to knee, reach for your kick. It's okay if you're kicking a lot lower. I want you to really work to keep this head coming right back up, nice and tall. We're getting some nice ab work here, decreasing the distance between our lower rib and the hip. And there's a bit of a balance challenge as well. If this is too much on your shoulders, instead of having those arms up overhead, you can always reach your arms down by the side. Oh my gosh, that was a little weird feeling. Do the best that you can. If you need to stop for a moment, catch your breath, stop for a moment, shake those shoulders out. We're gonna take a 10 second break and then switch to the opposite side. 3, 2, 1. Awesome, here's your 10 seconds, just shake it out. I know my standing stabilizing leg was getting real tired there. Plant your opposite foot down on the floor. Bring the weight into your heel, chest lifted, shoulders down and back, belly in, begin. Elbow to knee crunch, find that forward kick. So we're getting that knee a little closer to one elbow and then the other. I'm really working to drive that knee out to the side, just like we did in that third hip flexor warm-up move, of finding that range of motion that works for you. So my inner thigh is as much in line with the wall in front of me as possible. Whoa. Remember, keep those eyes focused. I moved where I was looking and I immediately fell. Make sure you're still breathing. You got just about 15 seconds left right here. Ooh. Starting to feel it. Hopefully you are too, as we're getting to the end. Final 5 seconds. We're gonna get a good stretch in next. Yay, last one. Oh, you're amazing. Take it down, shake it out. Let's go ahead, open those feet nice and wide. Bend your knees, take a big inhale. Stretch those arms up overhead. Have your toes pointing forward right now, heels invisible behind your toes. Bring your arms down parallel to the floor, in line with your shoulders, belly in. We're just gonna hinge forward. Coming down with a nice flat back. So still finding length through the crown of your head. Bring your hands down towards the floor. And if you need to, you can really bring those hands down in front of you. So we're shifting from having hips going towards the back of the room to having hips right on top of those heels. Shake it out for just a second. Relax your breath. Oh yeah. Keep one hand down on the floor. Let's take a big twist. Inhale the opposite arm up towards the ceiling. Still working to have some length through that spine. So if your hand's too close, you're gonna be really crunched in. Better to be a little further forward. Maybe you even have to separate your feet a little bit more to find a nice twist. Find length of shoulders away from ears. Keep that belly drawn in. And then exhale, bring your opposite hand back to the floor. And let's switch. Find this nice length, working to stack. Remember your hips on top of your heels, your hand palm underneath of those shoulders. You can look up towards the ceiling. Makes balance a little more challenging if you look up. And then exhale, bring that hand back towards the floor. Walk your hands over towards one leg. Slow down and relax your breath. Walk your hands over to the other leg. So good. Hands back towards center. We're gonna try and get a little bit deeper in this forward fold. So take a moment, pick up your heels, Turn on the balls of your feet, heels come in, toes point up. We're gonna squat down just a little bit so you can start to walk your hands back. Then you can pick up your heels. So heels are behind toes and lift up those legs. See if you can get a little bit closer with your chest towards your thighs. And if you need to take and keep or keep bending your knees because your hamstrings are really tight, that's totally okay. Use your eyes to look in the direction that you want your body to go. So eyes pointing behind you. Let's again, you can turn on your heels, bend your knees, walk your hands back. And then lift up, heels move behind toes as you come into that forward fold. One more time, bend your knees, walk your fingers back behind you. And then exhale, lift up on those toes. After you lift up on the toes though, release the heels back towards the floor. Relax your head down towards the floor. Create some space of shoulders away from your ears. And then gently walk your hands back forward. We're gonna pick up our toes and turn on our heels to face the opposite side of the room. So we're coming into separate leg, head to knee. I want you to shift a little bit more weight towards your front foot. You might even need to shorten your step, and we're shifting the weight into our front foot to work to lift that hip up a little bit more. If you don't, then that hip's gonna drop and your back hip is gonna come up. If you really press through that back heel while lifting this front hip, you can get two hips in one line. Use your breath. You can have your hands on the floor. You can challenge your balance more by walking your hands together, maybe even bringing your palms together as you work to relax your forehead closer to your knee. Just do your best. Take some rounding through that upper back. Bring your forehead towards your knee. And then let's slowly come on out. So we're gonna pick up our toes, turn on our heels, walk our hands back to center. And then we're gonna do the same thing to the opposite side. Pick up your toes, turn on your heels, and face your opposite foot. You can shorten your stance as you need to. I'll turn this way so you can see a little bit more if you're looking. You can shorten that stance. You can have your back foot a little closer toward the front. I think a wider stance actually is a little bit easier. And then shift the weight into that front leg. Actively work to lift up that front leg hip. Press through your heel of your back leg to drop it down. You can keep your hands nice and separate. You can challenge your balance by walking them closer together and then work to bring your forehead to your knee. You can apply some pressure to the floor to bring forehead to your knee. A little throat choked compression sensation. Take your time, give it a try. And then slowly let's come on out. Walk your hands forward. Pick up your heels back into our forward fold. Use your next big exhale to relax into that forward fold a little bit more. Inhale up into a half lift. And let's turn towards our original foot. This time I want you to step the opposite leg back. Take a moment here in a lunge. Work to get your two hips square towards the floor. Let's inhale and bring those arms up into a nice crescent warrior. You can even take a bend of your elbows in cactus. Oh, squeeze those shoulder blades towards each other. Make sure there's still a bend in that front knee. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands down to the floor. Walk them forward. Shift the weight into your front leg. We're coming up into warrior three. You can keep both hands on the floor, or you can try a nice little twisted warrior. Go ahead. Extend. Fred, did you just eat my hair? You can extend one arm up towards the ceiling. Keeping your eyes on the floor makes balance a little bit easier. Fred, stop eating my hair. Looking up towards the ceiling makes balance a little bit harder. Having a bird pull on your hair makes balance a little bit harder. Go ahead, release that hand down to the floor. Try to lift the opposite one. Remember, it's okay if you fall out. You can get right back in. Release both hands down towards the floor. Carefully start to bring the weight into your standing leg heel and bring the opposite leg down into your lunge again. From here, we're gonna walk it forward. We're gonna come to the other side. Find find yourself back in that lunge. So actively bending your front leg. Inhale, lift your chest up, arms come up, back heels off the floor. Crescent warrior, you can bend your elbows, open up your chest, squeeze your shoulder blades towards each other. Inhale, arms come up back overhead. Chin comes back in line with your chest, and exhale, hands come down towards the floor. Bring them forward of your foot, shift the weight into your front foot, and lift that back leg up off of the mat. Find as much length as you can through the crown of your head, through your back. Place one hand down on the floor or on a prop and inhale the other arm up towards the ceiling. You can look up towards the ceiling and really challenge your balance or keep eyes on the floor. Release that hand down to your mat. Extend your opposite arm up towards the ceiling. On your exhale, release it down towards the floor. Go ahead, carefully bring that back leg back down. Walk hands back to center one more time. Toes pointed forward, heels invisible behind your toes. Go ahead, bend that one leg. Take a nice side lunge here. Really work to press the outer edge of your foot into the mat to feel the stretch on your inner and outer thighs. And then let's walk it over to the other side. Really working to press the pinky toes edge into the mat as well. Walk your hands back to center. Heel toe your feet in towards each other. Ooh, bend your knees if you need to. And just take a moment right here in your dangle. Hopefully you're feeling a little bit more open on that back side of the body. Remember, you can generously bend your knees. You can be in a squat dangle and really support your belly on your thighs. Oh, take your time. Let's come on down to the mat. Bring your knees to the mat. Let's take a big stretch. You can open them if you want to. Bring your toes together. Send your hips back towards your heels. Walk your hands forward. Head releases down for child's pose. So we brought a lot of balance into the stretches that we just did. And that makes you use your core a little bit more. So hopefully you had some fun with those little challenges, almost a mini flow. Let's go ahead and bring ourselves back up to tabletop. Cat-cow a couple times in whatever direction feels good for you. Move slowly, just exploring how our bodies feel today. All right, let's get another ab challenge going. So next up, we're gonna do a little bit of bird dog. So we're gonna use opposite arm and opposite leg, but instead of bringing our elbow and knee to crunch together underneath, I want you to find a nice lat pull down. So keeping your hand palm, I'll do it on this side. Keeping your hand palm in line with your shoulder and still challenging that balance, and then pressing through your extended heel. So go ahead, starting in tabletop, make sure you're not sinking into those shoulders. Press into those hands, palms, take a lift of your chest. Really pull that belly in, keep that nice flat back. We're gonna extend opposite hand and opposite leg. I'm giving myself a thumbs up with my hands, and I'm really flexing my toes back towards the shin. So you can even come into a fire hydrant, really challenge your balance, work to bring your knee in line with your hip, and then extend it back out. Let's do that two more times. Really squeeze that elbow towards your hip, bring it back in, release down into tabletop, cat-cow it out. So I know we've done bird dog before, but just changing the direction that your body, that your legs are moving can really cause you to use your core a lot more for that balance. So hopefully you found it there. If you need to stick with the traditional bird dog, you can always reach it out, bring it back down, or reach it out, find that crunch, but we're gonna challenge ourselves once again to get a little bit more of a side body motion. Fred. So press into those hands, palms, draw that belly in. This time opposite leg extends, opposite arm extends. Give yourself that thumbs up, you're worth it, and then use your breath. Keeping your hand palm about in line with your shoulder, working to keep that knee up, And then extend behind you, press through your heel. Draw it in. Push out. One more time, bring it in. Push out. And then release it back down towards the mat. We're gonna do one more move here. So go ahead, tuck your toes under. We're gonna press ourselves up into bear. Work to keep those knees hovering just off of the mat. If that's really hard for you, I just want you to work between pressing yourself up and lowering yourself down. If you found that it was easier, we're gonna press ourselves up, tap your opposite shoulders. Let's go ahead, get going. Really work to keep your hands, palms under your shoulders. We got 20 more seconds right here. The more those knees just hover off the floor, the more challenging it's gonna be. The more those hips lift up, the easier it gets. 3, 2, 1. Awesome, release those knees down to the floor. Let's go ahead and turn over onto our backs. We're gonna get a stretch into our quads. Keep your weight nearby, because we'll use the weight right after we get this big stretch. So lay down on your back, draw your knees to your chest. Keep your lower back down on the floor. Elbows start to stretch towards your hips. As much of the back of your head and neck flat on the mat. Take the next couple seconds to enjoy some deep breaths. Slow down your exhale. Slow down that heart rate. All right, big old quad stretch right here. We're gonna take one hand and put it on top of the opposite knee. Then we're gonna take the knee that we're touching. That hand reaches under to grab hold of your foot. Bring the sole of your foot as close to the glutes as possible. Release the outer edge, pinky toe towards the mat. And as you press that knee, outside of the knee towards the floor, you feel that big stretch in the quads. Enjoy some deep breaths. Make sure you didn't come into a stretch that's so deep that it limits your breathing. If so, back out just a little. All right, and change carefully. Bring both knees back to your chest again. If you want, you can even rock gently side to side. And let's go ahead and get the opposite side. So one hand comes on top of the opposite shin. The shin that we're touching, that hand reaches underneath. You bring the sole of your foot close towards your glute. Edge of the pinky toe foot comes towards the mat. And you use that exhale to start to press the outer edge of the knee to the floor. You don't have to hold on to that hand, if it feels too far away. You can still work to open that inner thigh and feel the stretch on the quad, a little in the outer thigh. Slow down your breath once more. And then go ahead, draw both knees in towards your chest. Release the soles of the feet down to the mat. Go ahead, extend your legs out in front of you. Oh, we're doing so great on time. All right, so next up, we're gonna bring in some ab work. And here's where the weight comes into play. We have a lat pullover. So arms are gonna come up overhead, tapping down towards the mat in front of you. You can then bring your hands back up so that we're not throwing ourselves with the weight. And once the weight is back on top of your chest, you press gently into your heels to lift yourself up. From here, you're going to find a little straight arm Russian twist. You take a little bend. Think about making a rainbow. We'll say rainbow. And then arms come back up overhead. Carefully lower yourself down. And then tap those arms behind you. Go ahead and begin. So starting with ourselves flat, arms straight up towards the ceiling. Straight arms come down behind you as close as they can towards the floor. Inhale, arms back up over chest. Draw your belly in, press into your heels. Lift yourself up. From here, Russian twist, twist, back up overhead, twist, up overhead, slowly lower down. We'll do four more. Inhale up, lift your body,
find that.
Twist.
Slowly lower down.
Tap above head. Inhale up, lift your body. Twist.
Slowly lower down.
You know I already lost count. I'm saying that this is number three. Three of five. Slowly lower down. Make sure you're not rushing through things, especially the lowering and then this lifting of the arms. And then the body. If you're having trouble with these straight legs, bending your knees is going to make it a little bit easier to access those abs. But if you are somewhat experienced, I ask you to please challenge yourself with those straight legs. Nice work. One more lift. Let's twist, and then slowly lower down. Bring those arms up overhead. Relax that weight behind you. Find a big stretch through your body. Oh, feels so good. Take your time. Relax your arms down by your side. Let's get a nice stretch into the back of those legs. We really did do a lot of stretching already into the back of the legs, but I know that people's hamstrings get pretty tight from sitting at a desk. So go ahead, draw one knee in towards your chest and extend it up towards the ceiling. No need to use a strap today. Just finding the range of motion that works for you. If you want, you can grab hold of the back of your thigh. Maybe you just hold onto your pants to get a little bit more of a stretch. If there's a bend in your knee, that's also okay. Bend your opposite leg. Let's find a reclined pigeon. We're gonna challenge ourselves right here to take this a little bit deeper and go for a reclined double pigeon. So if you can, lift your chest up, work to stack both of those legs. They might not stack still, but you'll feel a much deeper stretch throughout the back side of your leg, of the glute, as you work to bring them in towards each other. Keep that lower back down the mat and take some relaxation through your shoulders. We're gonna carefully release that lower leg, extend it up towards the ceiling. Exhale, release it down towards the floor. Other leg up towards the ceiling, make some circles with your ankles, one direction, opposite direction. Release that knee down. Inhale the opposite leg up. First, just coming into that hamstring stretch again. As straight of a leg as feels good for your body today. Just breathing, feeling good. All the hard work is done. Just taking some stretches, getting our mind relaxed before we sit back at our desks or do whatever else you're doing for the day. Let's come into our thread the needle. Ooh, feeling real tight on this side. So remember, both sides are not the same. Do your best. We're gonna lift ourselves up, shoulders come up off the floor to reach towards the opposite foot as you can to work to stack those shins on top of each other. My shins will not be coming on top of each other in this direction. You can see that there is a lot of space, but can you flex your toes towards each other? Do you feel that big stretch while doing this throughout the back side of the leg and glute? Even some stimulation in the belly. Awesome. Go ahead, carefully release that lower leg down to the floor. Inhale, the top leg up towards the ceiling. Make some circles with your ankle in one direction. Make some circles with your ankle in the opposite direction. Go ahead, release that foot onto the floor. Press into your heels, lift your back up, relax your glutes, and let's go ahead, open those knees nice and wide. One more hip opener right here at the very end. If it feels uncomfortable to have your heels super close, remember you can always walk them a little further away. It starts to bring the stretch a little bit more into your lower back. Let's take three breaths here together. And if you have the time, I encourage you to stay down here on the floor for just a little bit more. Work to get a Savasana in, to just truly relax your breath, your body, your mind a little bit more, because you're worth it. take the time before you stand up to set an intention for the rest of the day. Maybe a mantra for yourself, just telling yourself that you are enough, how amazing you are for coming and making this to the workout, or setting an intention for something that you're going to do. Whatever it is, be kind to yourself, continue to think those good thoughts, speak good words, eat good foods, do good deeds. Take the time today to truly nourish yourself from the inside out. If you have any questions or concerns about anything that I said or we did, please reach out. Until we see each other again, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day.